I'm here with the number one boxing expert, the man behind Ring Magazine Online, Doug Fisher. I should be quiet how I say it. Kell Brook, Sean Porter, break it down.
Oh, I see an even fight.
50-50?
I mean, I'm hearing a lot of people saying that Kell Brook doesn't have the same fight experience as Sean Porter, but I disagree with that. I think Sean Porter has bigger names. His last two fights were against bigger names, but I think Paul Malignaggi, towards the end of his career, getting up there in age, kind of 1 foot already out of you know, competitive boxing in the broadcaster's booth. And with Devon Alexander, I think he caught him right. I think Devon Alexander, like a lot of people, and I admit it, I was overlooking Porter. I was looking at Porter like a prospect, not like a contender. And I think that's how Devon Alexander, who had hoped to secure a big money fight with Amir Khan, and it didn't happen, and who had scheduled a bunch of bouts with Kell Brook, and it didn't happen. I think, you know, maybe gearing up for fights and having them not happen, you know, maybe he was a little bit stale. I definitely think he overlooked on Sean Porter. I definitely know Kell Brook is not going to overlook Sean Porter. I mean, he wants that belt, so obviously he will have had his best camp ever. And I think when you look at the number of fights that Brook has, he has more fights than Sean Porter. No, there's no big, huge name. There's no Malignaggi or Devon Alexander on his resume, but a lot of tough guys, a lot of
Carlson,
solid
Jones.
Guys. Yeah, just a lot of
the
really...
The guy from Argentina,
Sinchenko,
and Tigre.
Yeah, the guy from Argentina. And I tell you what, the version of Carlson Jones that he fought the first time, he wasn't a ranked contender, but he was as tough and as formidable as any ranked contender, because Carlson Jones, very tough, very experienced, young athlete, very gifted athlete, and I know that he trained to win that fight. He was up in Big Bear with Abel Sanchez, and the version of Carlson Jones that extended Kell Brook, that guy would have beat a lot of top 10 welterweight contenders, and I think that fight was good for Brook because he had to fight hard for 12 rounds. And every up-and-coming contender, you need that tough fight, just like Porter had his first 10-round fight with Julio Diaz. He needed that. He needed that draw. He needed
like
that
Canelo
experience.
Like Canelo, Austin Trout. Like,
absolutely.
You want that challenge.
You got to have that. So I see them both equal experience, and I think that they're both equal athletes. They're different athletes. Porter's more brute strength. He's got that kind of mauler
Mini
strength.
Mini Tyson, as
yeah.
they say.
But I think that Brook is a more fluid athlete. He's a bit quicker, and I think both guys can crack. Both guys are unbeaten. They don't know how to lose. So, I mean, I just see a toss-up fight. If there's any edge I give Porter, it's just because the fight's in the United States. And that's really it.
Okay.
It's a flip-a-coin fight, honestly.
One more question. Doug Fisher here, boxing expert. Amir Khan, Robert Guerrero, a lot of buzz about this. It hasn't been. It's not official. But what do you think if it happens?
You know, Robert Guerrero's always in a good fight. He's dangerous because he's rugged. He's got that one thing that Amir Khan doesn't have, and that's durability. I mean, you could throw a brick at Robert Guerrero's head, and he'll laugh at you. He's smart. He likes it a little bit. You know, there's a part of him that's a little bit... The Guerrero's a little bit crazy. You know, that's not an act. Ruben Guerrero is dead. That's him. That's him before any cameras were ever on him. He's always been a little bit local. Good people. Good people. The Guerrero's a very good family. And Robert Guerrero's one of the nicest guys in the game. But he's a little bit loco. And I think that's his one edge against Khan, who is the better boxer. You know, has a much better amateur background and is the far superior athlete. And now that, you know, Amir Khan is with Virgil Hunter, you're going to see more grabbing on the inside, and you're going to see a more cautious boxer, which makes him more difficult. I mean, the one thing trained by Freddie Roach and just with his own natural inclination to brawl, to fight when he doesn't have to fight, his impetuousness, that was kind of like his Achilles heel. That's why Danny Garcia clipped him. But you take that away, you make him more of a careful boxer. He's really, really hard to beat. So, I mean, I favor Amir Khan in that matchup. You know, Khan by decision, but it's always a tough fight when Robert Guerrero's involved.
There you have it, Doug Fisher. You can hear him on an international broadcast this weekend, right? All the way
yes,
in England.
That's true.
Stay tuned for EsNewsReporting.com. I'm Melissa, back reporting.